there, my name is Thiago and this is English Everywhere, the podcast that helps you improve your English. I want to invite you to join me every week to take you to the next level, listening to all kinds of content, stories, interviews, chats, and a lot more. Welcome to English Everywhere. Olá, ouvintes do Inglês Everywhere! Hoje eu trago para vocês mais um poema, um outro clássico da literatura, e o poema é o Annabel Lee, de Edgar Allan Poe. Observem que eu tenho trazido para vocês uma diversidade bem grande de conteúdo, poemas, histórias, entrevistas, bate-papos, e dessa forma você consegue ouvir uma diversidade muito grande de tipo de linguagem, né? Tanto da poesia, da arte, quanto de histórias adaptadas, assim como outras situações em que a gente usa o inglês de forma mais espontânea, como nas entrevistas e nos bate-papos. Antes da gente aprender um pouquinho mais sobre quem foi Edgar Allan Poe e o poema do episódio, eu vou trazer para vocês, então, três palavras, três expressões que aparecem no poema. A primeira delas é o verbo covet. Covet. Que significa cobiçar. O exemplo que eu vou trazer para vocês não aparece no poema, tá? Eu peguei um outro exemplo para vocês observarem outros usos do verbo. She coveted his job so openly that conversations between them were tense. She coveted his job so openly that conversations between them were tense. A segunda palavra que eu selecionei é também um verbo, que é o verbo envy. Envy. Envy significa invejar. Um exemplo, então, com a aplicação do verbo. I envy her ability to talk to people she's never met before. I envy her ability to talk to people she's never met before. E, por fim, eu tenho a expressão by far. By far, que significa de longe, claramente, normalmente é utilizado no superlativo ou comparativo. O exemplo que eu trouxe para vocês hoje é o seguinte. They are by far the best students in the class. They are by far the best students in the class. Vamos então agora para uma introdução bem rápida para a gente entender um pouquinho quem foi Edgar Allan Poe e na sequência a gente tem então o poema. Edgar Allan Poe was an American author, poet, editor, and literary critic, considered part of the American Romantic movement. Best known for his tales of mystery and the macabre, Poe was one of the earliest American practitioners of the short story and is considered the inventor of the detective fiction genre. He is further credited with contributing to the emerging genre of science fiction. He was the first well-known American writer to try to earn a living through writing alone, resulting in a financially difficult life and career. Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe. It was many and many a year ago, in a kingdom by the sea, that a maiden there lived, whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee. And this maiden, she lived with no other thought than to love and be loved by me. I was a child, and she was a child, in this kingdom by the sea. But we loved with a love that was more than love, I and my Annabel Lee, with a love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me. And this was the reason that long ago, in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out of a cloud, chilling my beautiful Annabel Lee, so that her high-born kinsmen came and bore her away from me, to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea. The angels, not half so happy in heaven, went envying her and me. Yes, that was the reason, as all men know in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of the cloud by night, chilling and killing my Annabel Lee. But our love, it was stronger by far than the love of those who were older than we, of many far wiser than we. And neither the angels in heaven above, nor the demons down under the sea, can ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabel Lee. For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And so, all the night tide, I lie down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride, in the sepulcher there by the sea, in her tomb, by the sounding sea. Thanks for listening. You can send me suggestions on Twitter, Instagram, or by voice message. Also, follow us on your favorite streaming platform to check out for the next episode. On ingleseverywherepodcast.wordpress.com, you can have some further information about our show episodes, including transcripts. See ya!